I have a question for you guys. Imagine you have to travel in your two-wheeler. In that case, what are the different documents that you carry along with you and what are the other activities that you take care of? You will definitely carry the registration certificate of the vehicle. You will carry the insurance document of the vehicle. You will definitely take care of your driving license and you will also carry the emission certificate if it is applicable for you. And then you will carry your helmet also. Now, are you seriously concerned with your safety and that is the reason you are carrying all these documents? Most of the time, it is not that. You are scared of traffic police. That is why you are carrying all these stuffs so that you can avoid fines. Now, we are all scared of punishment part. Now, there are three different parts. One, the legislature, which is making law, for example, the traffic rules and other stuff. And then the executive part, which is ensuring that the laws are implemented correctly. In my example, it is the traffic police. And then we have the judiciary part, which is ensuring that there is no breach. And if there are any breach, there will be punishment in the form of jails and other stuff. And then the form of fines. That is what we have discussed in my case also. Now, because of this structured approach, nobody wants to breach the municipal law or the national laws. What happens with international law? Do we have a sovereign or legislature which is making law? Does it have a command or can it sanction the punishment? Now, these are the questions which are arises when we discuss the international law. That is why there is a lot of people who pose this question, is international law a true law? Now, there are two teams. One says, no, this is not a true law. The other part says, yes, it is a true law. We are going to discuss both the parties and then I'm also going to give you guys on the current scenario of international law, which makes whether the international law is a true law or not. Hey guys, welcome to my legal classes. This is Ganesh Pujari and let us discuss in detail on is international law a true law. Let us start the discussion with the party which says international law is not a true law. I hope you have all studied the subject of jurisprudence where we have studied the analytical school of jurisprudence. And if you see, the analytical school completely denies that international law is a true law. They say it is not at all a true law. Now, John Austin, one of the major jurists of analytical school, or he is also the father of analytical school, who says command, sovereign and sanction are the three major requirements for any law. And in the case of international law, all of them are missing. Like there is no legislature which can be made by sovereign, and there is no power of command, and there is no punishment also available in international law. It is just rules made for conduct of moral things, and it is all about opinions or sentiments available among nations. So this is all general laws, so this cannot be considered as laws as per John Austin. And John Austin's three major thing, that is command, sovereign and sanction, should be part of your answer so that you can make sure that you gain score there. He says, as the international law missing all these three parts, there is no way we can consider international law as a true law. The teacher of John Austin and the father of jurisprudence, that is Jeremy Bentham, along with Hobbes and Pfufendorf, also believes that international laws are not true law, because they don't have any binding power and they are not above the state laws. Now, in any municipal law or a state law or a law at national level, they have three important parts, that is legislature, administrative and judiciary. And as international law is missing them, they cannot be considered as true law as per these three jurists. While John Austin, Jeremy Bentham, etc. were saying international law is not a true law, Holland gone one step forward and said international law as the vanishing point of jurisprudence, because they don't have the sovereign or one of the most important aspect of municipal law, that is sanction. So they cannot consider it as any kind of law. That is what Holland has to say. Now, the international laws are also considered as weak laws by many of the other jurists. And this is all that you need to remember when it comes to the parties who say international laws are not a true law. I will make a separate video on Holland's view, that is international law as the vanishing point of jurisprudence, so that you can have more detail on that particular aspect. While jurists like Austin, Hall and Jeremy Bentham were believing that international laws are not a true law, there were few other jurists who believed that international laws are true laws. The major among them are Hall and Lawrence. Now, they said, just like any municipal law, the source of international law is also customs and precedent. As the sources are same, we should consider international law as true law, and we should also treat international laws as positive law. And they also said that international law is habitually treated and enforced as law. Now, this is what Hall and Lawrence to say. Pete Covert also opinions that international law must rank with laws and not with morality. The next thinking is coming from Sir Frederick Pollock, which is very interesting, who says there are three essential conditions for existence of law. They are the existence of political community, and such political community should be recognized by its members, and they should settle rules binding upon them in that capacity. If all of them are there, then those should be considered as true laws, and as international law is having all of them, or as it is satisfying all these conditions, the international law should also be considered as true law, is what Sir Frederick Pollock has to say. That is his thought. Now, if you want me to conclude this, that whether this is a true law or not, whether should I go with the analytical school, that is Austin, Jeremy Bentham or Holland, or along with Holland, Lawrence, Pete Covert and Sir Frederick Pollock, I will say all of them were right according to their timeline that they have defined. Now, when Austin, Holland or Jeremy Bentham defined the international law, there was nothing like the world wars have happened, or there were no major conventions, or there were no major treaties. So they thought there was no sovereign, there is no command, or there is no sanction. But in today's scenario, most of the states after the world wars have agreed that there is legal rules required for the entire world to manage it in peace and required way. And then we also started believing, and we started bringing the concept of pacta sunt servanda in many of the treaties. That means promises must be kept, and this concept is respected by many of the nations. So in the current scenario, though the earlier parties said the international laws were not true laws, and then we started believing the international laws are true laws, if you ask me, with the current trend, it is turning to be true laws with a kind of pacta sunt servanda, or the legal binding, or the pressure that the international community is putting on the parties which are not following international law. With all those situations, the international laws are also gaining more and more power day by day. So they have defined as per their timeline, and with the timeline, slowly international law has gained more and more power, and slowly it is becoming a true law. That is what I have to say. While discussing this topic, there were two important terms that I have mentioned. One, international law as vanishing point of jurisprudence, and then pacta sunt servanda. Now, these are the two important aspects which can be an independent question. So, I am going to post two independent videos on this particular topic also, which might be very small videos. And thank you so much for subscribing my channel if you have already subscribed my channel. If you are yet to subscribe my channel, this is your time to subscribe my channel. Please like, share and comment my videos. All the very best for whatsoever purpose you are watching my videos, and thanks for watching me.